Thank you. Amen. What a wonderful time to be alive. What a wonderful time to praise the name of our Lord. Hallelujah. Amen. Thank you, worship team. Hallelujah. Amen. For those of you watching us, amen. What a wonderful time to be able to give glory and honor to our Lord. Amen. Well, it's Sunday, the 1st of November, and this is the first time in many months that we are able to reach you from the church hall. Amen. The restrictions are not easy yet for us to be able to gather together again as a church. But believe me, that day is coming and it's coming soon. Amen. Hallelujah. At this moment, I want you to just lift up your hands with me, begin to glorify the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. It's very, very important that we give Him praise and give Him honor. Hallelujah. Oh, lift up your hands and begin to praise Him. Hallelujah. Amen. We're just going to enter into a time of prayer at this time. Amen. So, even though you are home, I want you to switch up your mindset as if you are church. Amen. Your home becomes church this morning. Amen. Hallelujah. Begin to lift up your hands and begin to praise Him and thank Him. Hallelujah. Oh, yes, Lord, we thank You. Amen. We give You praise. We give You honor. Hallelujah. We thank You, oh God. Hallelujah. Oh, we give You all the glory, all the adoration. Because there is no one like You, oh God. Hallelujah. Oh, thank Him for the daily gift of life. Hallelujah. Thank Him for His goodness, His mercy. Hallelujah. Oh, thank Him for answering our prayers. Hallelujah. Oh, yes, Lord, we thank You. We give You praise, oh God. Hallelujah. Oh, we pray many petitions unto our God, and He has been faithful in answering every one of them. Yes, Lord, we bless You. Hallelujah. For Your goodness, we bless You. Amen. Even this time, I want you to begin to pray for your family. Hallelujah. Begin to cover your family with the blood of Jesus. Hallelujah. Begin to speak good things concerning your family. Hallelujah. Peace in your home. Hallelujah. Prosperity. Hallelujah. Yes, good health. Amen. Yes, Lord. Hallelujah. Oh, yes, Lord, we just speak Your peace upon our homes in the name of Jesus. We speak Your good health upon our lives and our bodies in the name of Jesus. Oh, we thank You, oh God. We just pray for provision, oh God, in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Even this time, I want you to join me. Hallelujah. Let's begin to pray for the community. Amen. Let's just pray. Hallelujah. In Victoria, today, there were zero cases. Hallelujah. Let's begin to pray that God will continue to keep our community safe, keep our state safe, keep everything concerning us safe. Yes, in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Oh, that this virus, by the power in the name of Jesus, should continue to be put down in the name of Jesus. Oh, the control will continue. Hallelujah. Oh, it will continue to be suppressed and eliminated. In Jesus' name. Yes, Lord, we thank You. Hallelujah. Oh, yes, Lord, we thank You for the suppression. In Jesus' name. Yes, Lord, we believe in You for total elimination. In the name of Jesus. Yes, Lord, we bless You. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Now, people of God, I want you to join me. We're going to pray for America. Hallelujah. By this time, next Wednesday, we're probably going to be hearing the results. Amen. Time will fail me to go into any form of analysis, but as you know, we are apolitical. That means we do not support any particular candidate or any particular party. We can't even anyway because we're not Americans. Amen. But we're going to pray for America. Hallelujah. Because you know the central position America plays in the world. Therefore, it is our duty to pray that there be peace in that nation. Hallelujah. So join me right now. Begin to pray. Hallelujah. As America goes into election. In 2 days' time, hallelujah, let us begin to pray now in the name of Jesus that God will begin to bless that country, but much more that God will bring peace in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. We speak peace unto America in Jesus' name. We speak peace in the streets of America in Jesus' name. Every right spirit in the name of Jesus will bring it down. Every spirit of dissension will bring it down in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Every attempt by the imaginations of man, oh, to destabilize that nation. Father, we bring it down right now in the name of Jesus. And we lift up America before You. Father, we ask that You take control, oh God. Hallelujah. We ask that You take control, oh God. And Father, we also ask, oh God, hallelujah, that You put Your man into that position, oh God, in Jesus' name. of men. Hallelujah. Oh, you bring one out and you bring one down. Hallelujah. Oh, you reign, oh God. Therefore, Lord, we pray, oh God, your will be done, oh God, in Jesus' name. Your will be done concerning the election, oh God. And your selection, oh God, the person that you have appointed will sit on that throne. Yes, Lord, we bless you. We give you glory, oh God. Hallelujah. Father, we thank you because we know this is the confidence that we have in approaching you.
Yes, Lord.
Because we know, God, that every time we approach you and we pray according to your will, we know that you hear us. And when we know that you hear us, we are confident that we have a petition wherewith we are petitioning you. Lord God, we thank you this morning, O God. We bring this service before you. Father, it is not just another service, O God. We're not just gathered here just to fill our time, O God, just to fill space. Lord, we're gathered because we want to fellowship with you, because we want to hear from you, because we want to touch from you this morning, O God. Father, O God, we bring the rest of the service before you. Let your name be magnified, O God, in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. So I want you to gather your family around now. It's time to greet each other. Amen. I just give your family members a high five as you stay there. Hallelujah. Amen. Greet them in the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Oh, yes. We speak peace into your household, even right now, in Jesus' name. Amen. And now we're going to call on the singers and the musicians, the leaders, as we give unto the Lord. Amen. Offering time. Amen. We take our tithe and our offerings. Amen.
Jesus.
partakers of your kingdom this morning. Father, we thank you, O God, because you gave unto us so that we'll be blessed and be able to give back. Father, in the name of Jesus, we'll bring the tithes, we'll bring the offering unto you this morning. We pray, O God, a good measure. Press down, shake it together, and run it over. Shall men bring unto our bosom in Jesus' name. Yes, Lord, we rebuke the hand of the devourer and we declare, O God, oh, you pour us a window of blessing, O God, that we will not be able to contain. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. We've come to the highlight of today, which is hearing from the Lord. Amen. So I want you to gather your family together. Amen. I will try and make sure there's no distractions around you. Amen. Because it's time to hear the word of the Lord. Hallelujah. And we're going to invite God's servant, amen. We're going to invite Reverend Dr. William Osagede as he comes and deliver God's mind for us this morning. Amen. Let's put our hands together.
Good morning, everybody. It's good to be here again. We are becoming accustomed a little bit to this type of ministry, which is not very good because I want to see you face to face. But this is how we are now, so we have no choice but to say thank you, Lord, for the opportunity to come into your living rooms and that your whatever you are watching us, maybe in your car, maybe in your space, whatever you watch, Lord, we thank God for the opportunity to come to your living room. It's such an honor to bring God's word, but I wish we are in the house of God, and those of you around the world who are able to meet in churches, you are blessed. So pray for us here in Victoria that God will give us an open door. We are earnestly praying. We just don't want 5 people. We want a church, a whole house of God. So if you are also here with me and Victoria, please pray with us. We don't want to continue like this. We want to be able to come face to face, see your face, fellowship with you, and have a time of great rejoicing. We cannot just keep on pretending that everything is okay. It's not okay. I really feel that there's a spiritual oppression going on against the people of God. So we got to break that oppression. We got to come out of that, and we got to declare that we are more than conquerors. Hallelujah. Anyway, lift your hand with me, Father. Hallelujah. Blessed be your name. Thank you, Father. We honor you. We praise you. Hallelujah. Well, before we pray this morning, if you are in your home, can you do me a favor? Please stand on your feet wherever you are in your home, and let's read the word of God together. Can you stand on your feet? Hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Stand on your feet. Tura baba shatarama santelebu shukara baranda sandai. Stand on your feet. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Yes, yes. Just stand a little bit on your feet so we can read God's word together. While you are still standing there, I open the Bible to Matthew chapter 25. I know that it's becoming like a custom for us to just sit down there. So today, please, if you don't mind to stand, I can see you, but you be honest with yourself. If you can just stand, Matthew chapter 25, and let's read from verse number 1, because I believe God wants to speak to us this morning. Hallelujah. Verse number 1. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The Bible says in Matthew chapter 25, verse number 1, then shall the kingdom of God, the kingdom of heaven, be likened unto 10 virgins. Somebody say 10 virgins. Yeah, 10 virgins. You can write it down on your screen. Hallelujah. 10 virgins, which took their lamps and they went forth to meet the bridegroom. The Bible said, 5 of them were wise and 5 were foolish. And they that were foolish took their lamps and took no oil with them, but the wise took oil in their vessels with their lamps. While the bridegroom tarried, all slumbered and slept. You know, it's so important to remember that all of them, they slumbered and slept. The Bible says in verse 6, and at midnight, now look at that word midnight. Midnight, there was a cry made, and the cry was, behold, the bridegroom cometh. Come ye and meet him. The Bible says in verse 7, then all of them, again, mark the word all, yeah? All the virgins arose and trimmed their lamps, and the foolish said unto the wise, give us some of your oil, for our lamps are gone out. But the wise answered, saying, not so, lest there be not enough for us and you. But you go and enter to them and sell, to them that sell, and buy for yourselves. And while they went to buy, the bridegroom came, and they that were not ready went, and they that were ready went with him to the marriage, and the door was shut. Look at verse 11. Afterwards came also the other virgin, saying, Lord, Lord, open to us. But he answered and said unto them, Verily I say unto you, I know you not. Watch therefore, for you do not know the day nor the hour when the Son of Man cometh. Hallelujah. While we are still praying this morning, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. The word of God is powerful. The word of God is real. I want to bring the word again to you this morning. I have already spoken on this word long ago, but I want to talk about maintaining strong connections. Maintaining strong connections. People of God, what we have read right now has become so clear to me that every one of us, whatever we are watching this moment, we can liken ourselves to this five foolish or five wise virgins. These people, they had the opportunity to meet the bridegroom. They were preparing, all of them, they were all preparing for the bridegroom. But the foolish one and the wise one, you know, I love the Bible. The Bible is very clear, it's very explicit. It tells you as it is. Some were wise, some were foolish. It did not polish it, it just made it very clear. Some were wise and were foolish. I come to understand that foolishness is something that comes to you if you are not a person that observes times and seasons. But the Bible says that some were wise and some were foolish. Five were wise and five were foolish. Now, what is the definition? How do you know a foolish person and a wise person? Let's continue a little bit. A wise person prepares himself. A wise person is a diligent person. A diligent person that prepares himself before the opportunity comes. For example, if you are being called to come and sing or perform or do something, an examination, you don't just say, okay, I'm going to go. No, no. You prepare before the examination. You get ready before the time comes. And so a wise person, a diligent person, prepares himself before the opportunity comes. A diligent person remembers that there's a time to get ready. He knows that no matter what, there's an examination to be taken, so he prepares himself before the opportunity comes. A diligent person gets ready, he's in time, he's prepared, he's ready, everything, he's making sure that nothing takes away from him. That's a diligent person. That's a wise person. You know, if the president of our country or the prime minister or whoever is coming to your school or to your club or to your society, there's a thing we all do. We all get ready. We all get prepared. And we look for the best singers. We look for the best performers. We look for the best people who are going to perform very well. We don't choose the worst one. We don't choose a novice. We choose a very clever, we choose a high performer to perform for the prime minister. You know what, friend? Those people have practiced. They've been preparing. They don't just go, oh, the prime minister is coming. Oh, let's get ready. No. They've been preparing for a long time. That is what we call them professional singers. We call them professional, whatever you want to call them. But you know what? Because of their preparation. Now, friend, here comes a very interesting story here. Because sometimes in the Christian dom, I see Christians have become lazy. I see Christians have forgotten the most important thing when they go to church. I see Christians have forgotten what we are waiting for. My brother, my sister, with this pandemic, a lot of things have come to be shown among people. It has come to show the deafness, the carnality, the lukewarmness, the worthiness among many, many people. People of God, people think that, you know what, God has gone on a holiday. Can I just say this clearly to you right now? Whatever you are watching right now, there is one thing you got to remember. A day will come when the sky will split open and our Lord and our Savior, he will come and take us to his kingdom. A day will come when the rapture of the church will come. That is the greatest expectation of every child of God. The Bible says the kingdom of God is not meat and drink, but righteousness, but peace and joy in the Holy Ghost. We are waiting for that glorious coming of our great God and Savior. That's what we are waiting for. We're not sitting in our churches or waiting and thinking, oh, well, let me have a bit of fun. Let me have a bit of enjoy. Let me have a bit of that, even though you want it. But our main aim is to prepare our heart and our mind for the kingdom of God. Just like these five foolish virgins. Five virgins and five wise and five foolish. They were preparing for the coming of the bridegroom. They were preparing for the coming of the bridegroom. Can I just say this right now to you? The Bible says, and the five
five of them were wise and five were foolish. But the five took extra oil. I love this one. They took extra oil. They did not take anything to chance. You know what the Bible says? He said, at midnight, can I just say this? When the pandemic came at midnight, when the problem came at midnight, when everything was dark at midnight, when problem came, the five virgins, who were wise, knew that there's going to be a problem somewhere. And so they took extra oil in their vessel. They took extra oil. They were not willing to risk it because the King of Glory is worth anything. They prepared all. They sold. They bought more oil. Friend, can I say this to you? If you're a wise Christian, these are not the days to play tricks with your Christian life. You don't go on the beach. You don't go on the swimming pool. You don't go on anything and forsake the house of God. My brother, my sister, these are days to take on extra oil. Oh, but Pastor, I need to visit my football club. Even though you are not open right now. Also, church, I can't see you today. Pastor, I'm not going to church. Oh, no. I got to do my hair. It's a Sunday, you know. Pastor, I got to do my hair. No, Pastor. I got to work extra hours because Sunday penalty rate or the rate is better on a Sunday. So, Pastor, you know what? Give me a video break. I will watch the video later on. Friend, we are not just talking about video here. We are talking about you being part of the body of Christ. Amen. We are talking about you connecting with us, maintaining strong connection, maintaining strong spiritual connection. Friend, I want to say to you right now that every light in your house, that when you're going to put on the switch, it is connected to a main board, which is connected to the main power supply, which is connected to whatever company you are. There's that connection. When that connection is strong, you will get electricity in your house. But when there's a problem, like on Friday, there was a problem in somebody's area, and there was no electricity. People were in darkness. My brother, my sister, when you are connected to the light, you can see the light. When you are connected to the Savior, your light will shine. When you are connected to the King of Glory, you will continue going on. But once that connection is lost, that is where problem comes in. That's where grumbling comes in. That's where complaint comes in. That is where murmuring comes in. That is what we begin to wonder and say things in the flesh. Because I have found that some of us have allowed our connections. The five foolish virgins, they lost their connection. They forgot that the lamp will go down. Can I say this to you right now? Everybody watching me, whether you are a pastor, whether you are a deacon, whether you are an archbishop, everybody goes through trial times. Everybody goes through moments of up and down. We all go through sad moments. That's true. But the point of the matter is that some of people can recover quickly because they have an extra oil hidden somewhere that they can tap on. They have an extra anointing they can tap on. People of God, you know when the aeroplane is flying, some have got four tanks, some have got two tanks. The reason for that, maybe one tank of fuel is only going at the moment, but then as they continue, they open the other tank. They don't take chances. They are very careful. When the aeroplane, they make sure they fill it up to the brim. I remember a few years ago, an aeroplane in 1988 or so, Air Canada, almost crashed because they lost fuel. The fuel finished in the aircraft. And thank God, because the pilot was good, were able to land the aircraft without much damage. But you know what, friend? They forgot. They did not calculate properly the amount of fuel they need to take on the aircraft. Every aircraft, make sure that they have enough fuel, even abundant surplus for their journey. Why is it that Christians are so careless about their faith, about their Christian life, about their oil? Why do we allow the world to mold us? The world we live in, the news we are hearing, every single thing going on today is telling us that the coming of the Son of Man is at night. It's telling us that the rapture of the church will come very soon. It's telling us to get ready, get prepared, get ready. But friends, if you are a wise Christian, you will not only put more oil in your side, you will put an abundant more. You will get ready more. Your prayer life, your Christian life, your dedication life, your church going life will be stronger and stronger and stronger. Because you know that this generation is going to pass away soon. Because you know that your Savior is coming back again. The Bible says, if in this life we have hope, in Christ we are all men most miserable, but there's a hope because our Savior is coming back again. So if you know that our God is mighty, if you know then you're going to get yourself prepared. You're going to get extra oil. You're going to get extra. You don't just depend on the Sunday service only. Oh, I will just watch the tube on Sunday and that's the order. No, you don't just depend on that. You dive into your word of God. You daily study the word of God. You daily ask God for fresh oil. You daily ask God for a fresh anointing. You daily ask God to release you. You daily ask God to multiply. You daily ask God for more, because you are so ready. But the time you are used to grumble and complain and murmur and allow the flesh to rule you, then you forgot that your master is coming. Because the Bible tells me that the five foolish verses, they came and they knocked at the door of the wise one and they say, hey, five wise virgins, give us some of your oil, because it's already midnight, you see. Give us some of your oil, because our oil will run out. And the five wise virgins, they were clever. They said, hey, no, we do not give you more, because if we give you some of our oil, we may even run out. The bridegroom is coming. He is so precious. We don't want to miss the opportunity. But for you, you can go to the byway and buy for yourself. Friend, I want to look at this carefully, because I see it today. Believers need to be more filled with the Holy Spirit and with power. Believers need to be more filled. We don't have time to go around to look for extra oil. Get an extra container in your body. Get the extra oil flowing in your life. Let the anointing flow so much that you will have enough, more than enough, that when the crisis of life comes and try to zap you, you will send the Holy Ghost power. It will stop it. When the marriage problem comes, try to zap you, you will send the fire of God. It will stop it. When the evil comes, you will send the power of God to stop it. When the compromise comes, you will send the fire of God to stop it. Because you have too much. You have reserve. People of God, I come to see that the thing that drains our oil, the thing that drains our anointing, the thing that drains our fire is the world that we are living in. There is so much evil in this world. Trouble everywhere. Pain everywhere. Persecution everywhere. People of God, I'm speaking to you right now. You know what I'm talking about. You know, last people you woke up, you determined to serve God, but there were so many things coming against you. Your husband, your wife, your children, even the school system, even the work system, even the premier himself, even everybody were saying things, and your mind is not quivering, because the plan of the enemy has always been to quench that light, to cut off your connection, to make sure you're not connected, to make sure that your connection with the Father is broken, to make sure that your connection with the King of Glory is broken, to make sure that every time you wake up in the morning, every time you wake up, there's something trying to destroy you and take away the connection from you. That's what the enemy plans are. He wants to make sure he stops you from serving the Lord. You know what the Bible says in 1 John? The Bible says that that which we have seen, that which we handle, we declare unto you. And truly we say unto you, our fellowship is with the Father. Friend, from time immemorial, there have been wanting the enemy once more to destroy our fellowship and our relationship with the Father. The devil does not like it when you are singing psalms of praise to the Lord God Almighty. He doesn't like it when you are rejoicing. He doesn't like it when you hold your family's hands and you are praising the name of the Lord. He doesn't like it when you are pushing on. So he will make a plan to destroy that fellowship. What God wants more from you, my sister, is a fellowship together. There will be a connection between you and the Father so strong that the devil cannot touch it. But the devil fights you. He fights to break that relationship. He fights to make sure that you don't continue serving God. He fights to make sure you don't continue working with God. You know, I found one thing today that is terrible. Many people speak with their mouth. They say with their mouth, but their heart is far from God. Just speaking nice Christian words is not enough. Oh, hallelujah. Oh, praise the Lord. It's not enough. Yeah. Hey, those ones are just words. I say it many times. Oh, Pastor Willard, what a great preacher. That's not enough. I'm talking about you walking the walk. I'm talking about you living the life. I'm talking about you standing strong for what you believe. I'm talking about you taking a stand and say, devil, this is my time to shine for Jesus Christ. People are saying, I'm not going to serve God anymore, but as for me and my house, God, we serve the Lord. Your working place can wait. Hey, work. It is time for online church. Work, you can wait right now. As I'm talking to you right now, somebody may be cooking dinner. Hey, as I'm talking to you right now, they may be sweeping the floor. It is time to stop what we're doing and concentrate on the word of the living God. The word is powerful. The word is challenging. The word brings life. Somebody shout hallelujah.
Amen, amen, amen.
Today, you look around and say that, but Pastor, are the five wise virgins, they had the help of God. But you know what, it was their decision. They could have been like the foolish virgins. They could have taken no oil, but they decided to take extra with them. Friend, we got to take extra in these days. These days, there's the enemy's plan to drain us. You know, one of the things I've noticed in my life as well, it was that I have more time now to dedicate myself to God. I have more time now to spend with God. I have more time now to serve God. I can see so many distractions going on today. I can see many oppression going on today. The enemy wants to make sure that all of us fall down. But friend, I want to encourage you this morning. Take extra oil with you. I want to encourage you this morning. You got to be strong in the Lord right now. The Bible says, therefore, my beloved brethren, be strong in the Lord and the power of his might. We do not walk by sight, we walk by faith. It is time to take a stone strong and declare whom we are, because the darkness that is coming in this world is immense. There's a huge darkness coming. There's a huge darkness coming, and the darkness is so immense. If we are not careful, it will overthrow us. If we are not careful, it will take us away. If we are not careful, that darkness will destroy us. Friend, can I encourage you right now to take on the armor of Christ, to stand firm in the midst of all the evil? I encourage you right now to let the King of Glory shine. I encourage you right now to let the power of God shine. I encourage you right now, don't allow the enemy to take over your life. My brother, my sister, these are the days of Elijah, the days of the prophet, the days of the mighty man of God, the days of the King of Glory. You're going to rise up, my brother. You're going to rise up, my sister, and let the Holy Ghost power work in your life. Don't allow the power of darkness, don't allow sickness, don't allow Satan to overthrow you. You're going to rise up this morning and say, my God, my God, my God, I am going to serve you all my life. I am going to be a wise man. I'm going to be a wise woman. I will be cautious. I will be determined. I will be ready when everything is going on. I don't want my oil to be spent. I want to be so ready for the kingdom of God. I want to be so prepared. I want to be so in tune with the kingdom glory. My sister, my brother, you're going to remember that the devil want to push you away. All the fights, all the trouble, all the pain he's causing you right now. Remember the pain. Remember the confusion. Remember the problem coming to you. Remember the time when you thought you overcame, and all of a sudden things are crowding you. You're getting confused. You're asking questions. Satan wants to bring you to doubt. To doubt even your salvation. To doubt even if God is alive. To even doubt if you're a Christian. And all these doubts are coming in. A wise man told me many years ago. He said, Pastor William, when you are alone, guard your thoughts, for out of them come the issue of life. When you are with people, guard what you speak. And I come to realize it is so true. When you are alone, the thought bombard your mind. The thought will come. All those thoughts, and they will give you more confusion. Friend, remember, the only thing for us to meditate upon is the word of the living God. For the Bible says, the word shall not depart out of thy mouth, but thou shalt meditate upon it day and night. Don't allow the enemy to bring thought to your mind. Don't allow the thought to come to your mind. Meditate on the word of God. Let the word of God be real to you. Let it be powerful. Let it be glorious.
Amen.
Because the enemy, he is trying to quench your light. He's trying to make sure you don't continue. The enemy, he's trying to make sure you don't continue. And every day, every time there's a knock at your door, and that knock is saying, you can't go to church anymore. Look at you. Why don't you go back and start smoking your marijuana? Why don't you go back and start smoking your cigarette? Why don't you go back and start drinking your snap? Why don't you go back and start doing your fornication? And all this talk comes to your mind. And all of a sudden, you begin to wonder, oh my. And because of that, you allow the tail of the enemy to overcome you. Friend, you got to remember that God Almighty says, I am the way, I am the truth, I am the life. God has not changed his mind concerning your salvation. He has not changed his mind concerning what is going on. At midnight, during the pandemic, Because now, since we've been doing online church here at church, it's becoming so rare to see some people on our online church. I don't know what they're doing. I don't know what they have gone. No more excuse. Oh, Pastor, I can't come to church today because of my daughter, because of my son, but now the church is coming to your house. It's in your living room right there. Why don't you open it up and hear? Oh, I got to be busy. I got to wash my clothes. I got to do this. And all these excuses. You know why? Because your oil has gone dry. Because when your oil is full, when the anointing is full in your life, when the power of God is full in your life, you will seek to do the will of the Father. You will enjoy the will of the Father. You cannot wait to enter the house of the Father. You cannot wait to serve the Father. You are eager. You are happy. But people of God, that eagerness have gone. That desire have gone. That holiness have gone. Because you know what? The oil in your life has gone dry. Oh, hallelujah. Holy Spirit, help your people. Once the oil gone dry, and that is why so many people, even pastors, even bishops, they start manufacturing. They start thinking of what to do because, you know, the oil has drawn dry. There is no more fire going in their bones anymore. They are now manufacturing things. They say, Papa, God said the Lord, God said the Lord, I will build a temple, I will build you a house. What are all those things? Oh, said the Lord, I'm tired of hearing people saying things that are not gospel. I want to hear the mind of God. You don't tell me that God does not speak again. A man once said to me, he said, Pastor William, I went 40 days of 49 prayer. God has told me to tell you, you got to bring $50 to do this. And I'm saying, wow, a man that can spend 40 days and 40 nights in prayer, the thing he will hear from God is to bring money. My brother, if you spend time with God, God will show you the secret things of his kingdom. He will open to you the world. He will tell you what's going to happen. He will show you divine things. God will open doors for you. But friend, the problem is that we don't have the tenacity anymore. We don't have the grace anymore to spend time with the Father. Even when we're on Zoom. Even when we're on, when is it going to end? Because we have come to a place now where the connection between our Father and us, the wires are getting loose. Friend, what is your connection right now? Sister, how connected are you to the Father? Are you still connected? Is your light still shining? You know, I have been to many mission times in Africa and in Nepal and many of the undeveloped countries. One of the things that make me laugh always is that you see them with a generator. And they come with these tiny wires. They are trying to connect some things. And the wire is so tiny, you begin to wonder, how will it work? And they put the bulb there. And those tiny wires, I say, oh my goodness, you know. And then I come to realize, whether you like it or not, it's a connection. It works for them anyway. What am I saying right now? You see, that connection is so important for them to see the light for the crusade. Friend, you know, a time came. I was in the Philippines. I'll never forget this. We were going to preach the word of God. We went from house to house evangelizing, telling everybody in this village. And then lo and behold, it was about 7 p.m. and we were all gathering the people to come together to come to the crusade ground. And they all were coming. But all of a sudden, the electricity went off. And we all said, oh no, what do we do? The pastor came up to me and said, Pastor William, take the mic, wait for me. He went and he drove his car. He brought his car, he put it next to the crusade ground and put the light on. He said, Pastor, that's your electricity. You can preach now. Oh, I never forget that. With the light of the car light was shining and we're able to see and preach the gospel, and many people gave their life to Christ that day. Then I knew what it means to have the light. Because friends, God wants our light to shine. Whether the darkness may come, whether the pandemic may come, whether the enemy may come, whether the social may come, whether everything may come against us, we must keep on shining the light of the gospel. And friend, whether you like it or not, that connection, we must maintain it. We must maintain it continuously. Don't let anybody, don't let your neighbor, don't let the person that doesn't like you steal your anointing. Don't let them destroy the anointing in your life. Don't let them cut you off from the things of God. Don't let the people of the world, don't let food, don't let things shatter you. Friend, I want to speak to you this moment. I want to really bless and encourage you. Please stand strong. Please be careful, because there is a lot of things going on today to steal the fire of God. God in your life. That is why you are seeing many, many Christians saying a lot of rubbish on Facebook or on media, because they don't have any more to give. All they are talking about is humanity and psychology. We're going to go back to the man of God, to the woman of God. That's called the word of the living God. Tell us the word of God. Tell us what God said. Show us the way to the kingdom of God. Talk about all these psychological things. Let's forget about them. My friend, it is time for you. It is time for you, my sister, to trim off your light again. For the five wise virgins told the foolish ones, "We're sorry, we cannot give you our own oil, because lest peradventure we also run out. You can go now to the field." It was midnight, "You can go now and buy for yourself." Friend, there's a wisdom there. My brother, my sister, I always say it. Don't compromise your anointing. Don't give what God has given to you. I see many people who are called in the ministry. Some are evangelists, some are ministers, and they are saying, "I don't really think I'm called again." And they begin to give up their calling. They begin to give up their calling. You know why they are giving up their calling? For the enemy. You know, they are like Esau that sold his birthright for a morsel of porridge. You know, they are like that. What God has given to you, the fire that God has put in your heart, don't sell it, my brother. Don't give it up, my sister. Keep on standing, because it called the Lord Jesus, a Lord, to do that for you. Don't say, "Well, you know what, I'm going to stay right now." Because, you know, the five wise virgins were clever. They said, "We're not going to allow the oil in our lamp. We can't give you ours. You go and buy for yourself." That's what I keep on saying. Oh, somebody came up to me 7 years ago. He said, "Pastor William, I can see you are anointed. Can I have the same anointing?" I said, "Friend, you go and look for your own. You can't have mine. Go and buy. Go to the Father and get your own. I won't give you mine. I can't even do it. Go and get your own." Friend, don't let people take away what God has given to you. Don't let the enemy take away what God has given to you. You're going to be standing strong on the crown of God. I love the song that says, "I am standing on the rock. I am standing on the rock." Friend, in the days of pandemic in Victoria, Australia, in the days of pandemic in UK, London, in the days of pandemic in Rome, Italy, in the days of pandemic in Tampa, Florida, in the days of pandemic in Kenya, Nairobi, in the days of pandemic in Africa, Ghana, it is time to stand on the rock. In the day of pandemic in Latoka, Fiji, it is time to stand on the rock. In the time of pandemic in Apia, Samoa, it is time to stand on the rock. Let us stand on the rock. Let us stand on the rock. The rock is our King of glory. Let us not sell out. Let us not sell out. Let us not give in to the enemy, but keep our fire burning. Keep our fire burning. Friend, what about you today? What about you today? Are you about to say, "You know what? I can't take this anymore"? Somebody asked me the other day, they said, "Pastor William, what do you think about this pandemic?" I scratched my head. I said, "God has got a plan and a purpose. God is telling us something here. God is trying to show us way." "But Pastor, what do you mean?" Because God is saying to you and to I, stand firm when the trouble comes. Everything we see today are in the word of God. The word of God tells us, in these days, perilous times shall come. Men shall be lovers of their own self. Friends, stand firm. Sisters, stand firm. Brothers, stand firm. Don't allow the boss at work to derail your salvation. Don't allow the sweetest of the world to derail your salvation. You look at me and say, "But Pastor William, I am tired. I can't even go anywhere." You're not alone. I get frustrated because I can't go to what God called me to do. Many of my mission trips, I have canceled them because I couldn't travel out of the state. But you know what, friends? That does not mean I give up the light that God gives to me. I will keep on doing what God has called me to do. Because the Bible says that when they went to buy the oil, the bridegroom came. The bridegroom came. Oh, I love this story. The bridegroom came. You know why? People of God, the time you least expect, the time you are thinking of going back to your fornication life, the time you are thinking of going back to your adulterous life, the time you are thinking of doing your dubious things and deceitful, that is when the time the Lord will come. Because the Bible says, they know not when their Lord will come. That is why the Bible says, the bridegroom came, and then they came, and then he said, the people, the five that were the five wise virgins, went into the chamber with the bridegroom, and that was it, that the door was shut. Now, friend, I pray to God that the door is not shut for you, my brother, my sister. I pray to God that the door is not shut on anybody. But once that door is shut, nobody can open it. Nobody can open it. Because the five foolish virgins came and they were knocking. Bah, 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 master, master, master. He said to them, I don't even know you. Get away from me. I pray that will not be you. This is why I tell many people that just because you go to church and carry the emblem of a Christian does not mean, just because you speak nice Christian language does not mean anything. What it means is if you really walk with him. What it means if you can really stand for him. What it means is that in the time of adversity, if you will still serve the Lord, like Joshua said, as for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. People of God, wherever you are hearing me right now, please, for a few minutes right now, if you forget everything I said today, please don't forget it. For a few minutes right now, please tune in carefully to what I'm going to say right now. Please, tell your neighbor, don't disturb me right now. Your husband, don't disturb me right now. Focus on what God wants to tell you right now. God is calling you to live a holy life. God is calling you to stay strong. He is saying to you, I am coming back again. I am coming with the rapture. I will come and release my people from this world. But only those who are wise, who are ready, who are prepared, who are walking with me are going to go. Friend, are you going to be among those ones? People, please, I beg you. I beg you. I plead with you. In the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, be strong in the Lord. Don't allow the world to derail you. Don't let them push you and push you and push you. Stand strong. Keep on standing strong. For the Bible says, these are the days that we need to shine for the Lord. In the days of this pandemic, in the days of this difficulty, let us take our light and let us shine. But Pastor William, everybody is committing sin these days. I heard the other day that, the rate of adulterous relationship has gone high. I heard the other day that because of the lockdown, many people are doing that. And the sinfulness, the world has become so sexualized. Everything people do has got to do with sexuality. It's just too much. And it's increasing every day. The enemy is trying so hard to destroy our faith. Even when you see a Christian on television, you don't even know anymore if they are really Christian. When a preacher is preaching anymore, they don't quote the Bible anymore. People are scared to talk about the real issue. But friend, I want to say to you this morning, forget everything else. Prepare your heart, because the Lord will come when we least expect it. Let our heart be pure. Let our mind be pure. Let us surrender everything to the Father. Let us come to the Father and ask him to purify us. You know, the songwriter said, create in me a clean heart. In Psalm 51, he said, I make a right spirit within me. He said, wash me with hyssop and I shall be clean. Cast me not away from your presence. Oh God, renew a right spirit within me. Sister, brother, that is your prayer this morning. My brother, my sister, don't look around. Maybe you have allowed the world to overtake you. Maybe even as I'm speaking right now, you're no longer walking with God. Maybe you are just staying and watching and watching and watching and thinking, I will do my own thing. Please, I beg you, it is time to come back to the Savior. It is time to come back to the King of Glory. Maybe your business is affected and you're crying, there's no food in the house. Maybe things are going on with your family. People, don't let that hold you back. It doesn't even matter if everything you have at the moment does not anymore satisfy. But there is a God. There is the King of Glory. There is the I Am that I Am. There is Jehovah Jireh. There is the power of the King of Glory. He wants to touch you. Friend, the five wise virgins, they were careful enough to remember the word of their master. What did their master say? Watch ye therefore, watch therefore, watch therefore, for you know not the hour or the time or the moment when your master come. Friend, can you keep on watching right now? My brother in Victoria here, I know that at the moment we are passing through a very heavy lockdown and we are all wondering according. Many questions have been asked. I ask questions, I don't have answers to some of them. I don't know what is going on. I don't even know why all this, but what I do know is my God is still in control. I'm not going to let this announcement by these professors or people who know the science going to derail me. I have put my feet on the rock. The rock is the Lord Jesus Christ. I will not turn back. I will keep my feet standing. Because you know what, friend? The day will come when the Father will look at you and say, well done, good and faithful servant. As for me and my house, as for me and my wife, as for me and my children, we will praise the Lord. It is time for you, my brother. I'm going to ask Pastor Claire to give us some word and Mr. Claire to worship the Lord again. But right now, friend, I want to encourage you right now. Reach out this morning. Let the Holy Ghost touch your heart. Maybe you have been sliding down. Maybe there are things in your life right now that is not working well. Maybe you have allowed the depression to take over. Maybe right now you're no longer singing praises. Your praise has gone. You're no longer worshiping God as before. I want to pray with you. Rise up, my sister. Rise up, my sister. Rise up, my brother. Let us give the glory to the King of Glory, to the Almighty God, to the I Am That I Am, to the glorious King, to the Jehovah Jireh. He is still the Alpha. He is still the amazing God. He is still the powerful God. He is still the glorious God. Hallelujah. 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 Let him have his way in your life. Let him do his work in your life. Let him shine the light in your life. Let him do his work in your life. Friend, open your heart to the Lord. Be like the five wise virgins who got their oil in their lamp. They have oil in their lamp, but they took extra. Take it, the extra. You say, what is the extra? The extra is more of you dedicated to the Lord. Get filled more. You say, but Pastor, how? Get the word of God in your heart. Attend prayer meetings. You know, don't stay in your shop and start working when you know your church is going on. Don't stay in your bed and start sleeping when you know your church is going on. We cannot sleep. Arise. Wake up, you that sleepeth, for your night has passed and the day has come. Join up. Connect with the people of God. Maintain your connection. Connect with the house of God. Connect with the man of God. Connect with the people of God. You can keep doing that by online services. At the moment, we cannot meet in a building, but we can meet online. So connect with us. Connect with us. Pray with us. Stand with us. Rejoice with us. Let us see you in our women's meeting. Let us see you in our men's meeting. Let us see you in our youth meeting. Let us see you in our prayer meeting. Our Bible study. Let us see you worshiping go with us. Let us connect together. Let us maintain that connection so that the enemy will not overthrow us. These are the days. These are the hours. These are the moments. I tell you a story before we begin to pray. Pastor Clay worship. Hallelujah. As they begin to pray the worship right now, a young man told me, he said, Pastor, I had a dream. He said, in that dream, the rapture of the church came. He said, at that rapture, he said, I saw the Lord Jesus coming. He said, and the trumpet blew. He said, I saw people all going. They were all going with the rapture. They were all going. He said, his father and his mother, he was going as well. He was going, he was going, he was going. And the father and the mother, they came out to him. And the father grabbed his first leg. Mm. The mother grabbed his second leg. And they threw him down. And they said, you're going nowhere. Mm. And the man said, Pastor, what does that mean? I said, I don't need to go to far places to tell you what that means. I said, brother, your lifestyle at the moment is telling you, if the rapture comes now, you're going nowhere. God is warning you. God is speaking to you. You're going nowhere. Friend, I don't know about you, but if God is taking you right now, let's repent. Let's turn around. Let's take our heart again. Let's ask God to forgive us. Let's ask God to work in us. Let's ask God to create in us a clean spirit. Let's ask God to manifest his power, God. I want to be that woman or that man that will serve the Lord God Almighty, that will not allow a pandemic to derail my salvation. Oh, God, help me. Oh, God, I need you more. Oh, God, I need you now. Yes, hallelujah. Oh, God, I cry unto you. People of God, as you worship the Lord with this song right now, I'm going to ask you to stand in your home. Please stand in your home right now. I know that you've been sitting for a while if you are standing, but stand right now. As we exalt the Father, we're going to worship him. We're going to exalt him. And in that moment, let the Holy Ghost talk to you. Let him minister to you. I'm going to come back again to pray for you. We're also going to have our Zoom session, but right now it's time for you to journal. Let us exalt the King of Glory. Let us magnify the I Am That I Am. Let us cry unto him, for he is more than able. I'll come back to you again. Hallelujah. Zoom right now. Begin to connect on Zoom. Joshua will bring us. Begin to connect on Zoom right now. We're going to pray together. We're going to pray for one another. We're going to stand strong together. We're going to declare that we are not going to allow the enemy to stand against us, because this is our day. We're not going to let our oil to go dry. We're going to ask for the double portion today. So right now, begin to connect on Zoom. Hallelujah. Begin to connect on Zoom, because we want to pray with you. We want to join our hands with you. We want to declare with you. Our oil must never run dry. Hallelujah. We must have a spare. A spare fire, a spare anointing to continue going from glory to glory. But if you are watching on Facebook right now, and you, I want to lift up your hands, and on YouTube, let me pray with you. Hallelujah. We're going to sing that song again. If you are going to join on Zoom, we're going to sing that song and worship the Father. Father, I pray for all those who are watching right now on Facebook and on YouTube, that, oh God, you will experience, oh God, a mighty thing in their life, oh God. Father God, there are people crying out to you. They want your oil, oh God. They don't want to allow anything to stop them, oh God. Father, I pray right now, fill them with your anointing, oh God. Father, right now, receive it. Receive it. Lift up your hands. If you are in your home, I can't see you. You can lift up your hand. Hallelujah. Father, I pray right now for a fresh oil. I pray right now for a double portion, oh God. I pray right now that your people will not run dry. In the name of Jesus, I declare fire of God, oh God. Keep your church going, fire. Keep your people going, oh God. No man in hearing the sound of my voice will lose that you give it to him, oh God. I double anointing this week, oh God. Amen. Father God, those who are going back to school, I pray for your protection. I pray for your grace. I pray for your power. Our moms and our dads who are going to be homeschooling, I pray, Father God, that, oh God, you give them, oh God, more of your strength, oh God. They will not lose that thing you've given to them. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. So right now, my brother, my sister, jump on Zoom. Yeah, the details are there for you to jump right now. Hallelujah. We're going to pray together as a church. We're going to declare together. Hallelujah. We're going to continue worshiping the Lord. Right now, if you're on Zoom already, you can lift up your hands as we worship the Father. I want us to worship the Father. Hallelujah. People of God, these are days for our oil to keep on going higher and higher and higher. Let you know, Lord, try in your life this morning. Come on, go ahead. Go ahead, Pastor. Hallelujah. God bless you. We'll see you again next week. But we're on Zoom right now. So come on, Zoom. Hallelujah.